Hey, what's up, everybody? Velina Mike. Cool. My name is Jonah Davis, and today we're going to talk about a strumming pattern. Okay, now this is what I like to call a muted hand. Okay, so I really like playing with a muted hand. It's I don't know what else to call it, but that's what I like to call this playing style. I tend to do a lot of my instrumentals and my strumming exactly the same thing, utilizing these skills, okay, these techniques. So we're going to utilize, again, what's called a muted hand. Okay, now in this one we're going to talk about the chord hand. All right, so we're going to learn how to mute our chords as well as utilizing our strumming hand to help assist in the rhythm. So we have to really work a lot in terms of coordination. Okay, so this is such a very, I want to say mid-level to advanced. Yeah, but anybody can do it. I teach it to five-year-olds, so you know, you can even do it even at the beginner level, okay? So, but before we get started, go ahead and click the like button. I hope you find value in it. So be my YouTube bestie. Click that subscribe button, and then you'll get more when you come and visit. All right, guys, here we go. We're going to start right now with the F chord. I find it's probably the easiest chord to really start employing this technique and learning how to coordinate our hands, because our left hand, our chord hand, and our strumming hand, right hand for me, again, I'm a righty. If you're a lefty, it's going to be the opposite. You know, it's going to take a lot of coordination, and we want to make sure that they both work together. All right. So when I'm talking about a muted hand, you can mute on both sides. Sometimes I will mute my strumming, my picking hand, all right? Or sometimes I will mute just my chord hand. There are times where I will definitely mute both, okay? So today we're gonna focus on the chord hand, all right? Again, starting with your F chord. So E1 and G2. Now, while you're holding this chord, make sure you have good chord holding technique. So thumb should be firm but not stiff towards the halfway mark of your ukulele. It should be flexible, it should be movable. So however you want to hold your chord, whatever it might be, you know, you want to make sure that your thumb is movable. All right, okay, it's not stuck. You're not gripping, you're not pressing. Okay, now E1 with the index finger and G2, okay? The number represents the frets and the alphabet, the strings. Now make sure you can see through, you see where my index is right here? By the neck and the opening of my hand, you should be able to see through. This means you're properly holding a chord, okay? If you cannot see that, then that's not okay. It should always be open. Got it? All right, good. Moving on. Now, when we're holding our F chord, you want to take your ring finger and your pinky and lay it directly across all four strings. Okay, now, you don't want to press it. You just want to kind of create a nice little muted sound. Okay, if you press it, you're creating a chord, but we're just muting. So that is a sound we're looking for. Now, this is where it gets a little bit tricky. Now, for every time, the strumming pattern is going to be down, up, stop. Now, I am probably going to tap and not a full mute, but you could. I think they call that a chuck, right? Down, up, stop. Down, up, stop. Okay? So you can do that. In fact, yeah, let's use that. All right? So while holding your F chord, every single time you strum, you're simply going to lift. Okay? You're going to lift. So let's go ahead. We're breaking this strum down. Now, this strumming pattern, again, is down, up, stop. So for every single strum, you're simply going to lift. So down, and you're going to drop. Okay, so I strummed, okay, and then I dropped my ring and pinky. Now with my up strum, same thing, and my stop. Because to me, I'm starting to develop a habit, you might find me lifting and dropping even on the stop. Okay, so again, here we go, down, up, stop. Very good. So that coordination right there is very tricky. Take your time with it, all right? Now, again, if it gets frustrating, I like to tell my students this. Take a break, put it down, come back later, okay? You want to build a habit, okay? You want to start developing a habit. So the more you do it, simply doing it without being too, you know, don't overthink too much. Don't put too much stress and strain into learning it and practicing it. Make it a habitual practice. Okay? So that's one thing that I really try to stress to my kids and my adults. I always say this. Patterns. Music is patterns. And repetition is key. So that's all we're doing right now. We're creating patterns so that we start to get familiar with it, right? And then we start remembering it. It becomes a habit. And then repetition is key. We're creating muscle memory at that point. All right, so here we go. We're going to try it. One, two, ready, and down. Up. Down. Up. Down. Up. Full pattern. Down, up, stop. One, two, ready, and. Okay, very good. Now, when we get really good at it, this is what you want it to sound like. One, two, one, two, ready, and. One, two, ready, stop. All right, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that. That is a really cool technique, one of my favorite things. Again, that's probably the main technique that I like to employ in all of my songs, a muted hand. So there you go. That's what the muted hand looks like with your chord hand. All right, guys. Hey, visit me, jonahdavis.com. Join my email list, guys, for new newsletters, for insider info, and special releases that you'll only find in the email. All right. God bless you guys. Take care. See you guys soon. Aloha.